around, and then you're going to pass it through sideways.
Like that?
Yep. Lovely.
Good morning. It is Sunday today. What is the date?
You've got a better angle than me. Jealous of your vlogging.
It's 29th, so.
It's 29th of January, and I haven't filmed at all this week, but I did that intentionally because
hashtag
we
vlog 431.
No, vlog weekly vlog 27, I think.
4021.
We're gonna get there eventually. Yeah, we're going on a very exciting outing today. Where are we going? The big cat sanctuary.
The big cat sanctuary in Ashford in Kent.
In Kent, and we're going to feed the lions and the jaguars and. So I'm gonna get the guys there to tell you more about it, but it's all in aid of like conservation and rehab and like putting the big cats back out into the wild where they belong. So they do a lot of good work, and we are gonna find out more about it.
A bit bumpy this road.
It's a bit bumpy. Is because they're discussing the possibility of Sam being their patron, which he's so excited about because obviously he loves all the animals and these are particularly cool. So yeah, we're just getting a little guided tour, which is very, very kind of them. We are very grateful to be able to do these cool things. I'm never gonna leave. Oh my goodness, no, we're just a little bit overwhelmed. So this is Tiny.
How beautiful is he?
He's not that tiny.
He is compared to when they both stand up.
A lot, obviously, at zoos and places like this, you're going to get a lot of people who don't really know all about it that are going to ask, like, that are going to say, oh, it's bad because they're in cages and stuff. But I think you'll explain better than I would why it's good that they're here at least. Do you know what I mean?
Well, all of the cats here, they're either rescues or they're here as part of the breeding programs. So they've got to be somewhere, and in no way do we think that cats in captivity is ideal. It's certainly not. But there isn't really an option. In 20 years we could be without big cats if we don't have a captive population.
Yeah.
So our breeding is coordinated, and the cats go all around the world to maintain the healthy gene pools. So we've got a real strong objective in what we're doing. It's not just for an exhibit
proper mission.
Absolutely.
So we're just about to meet the cheetahs, and they do like touch exercises with them, and they do this. When I saw this on Sam's vlog, I was like, well, why are they making them do tricks? I don't really like that. But they do it because if they need to check their health, or they need to give them medicine or their heartbeat or anything like that, they've got two choices. They can either teach them to be domesticated and obedient and do it manually so they can get to them and touch them and get close to them, or they can dart them, which hurts them. So obviously the better choice for the cheetahs is to be conditioned to have humans around them and be okay with that. So in order to do that, obviously they have to work with them, which is what we're about to see now.
Part of the husbandry they do here is training, as in getting the cats to move into positions where we need them, and then we can do things like administer vaccinations, and we're hoping in the future to do blood tests and other injections, listen to their heart rate, that kind of thing, with stethoscopes. So we're going to show you some of that now. While Charlotte's doing the training, if we all keep noise to a minimum just so Murphy doesn't get confused, and then we can chat about what we did afterwards and explain everything. Sorry.
Daddy. Touch. Touch. Do you want down there? Touch. Daddy. Touch. Daddy. I'm not gonna lie, I'm shitting myself. Oh my god!
That was amazing.
I think my heart rate is like just thumping out of my neck. It was terrifying, but so cool. Oh look, we've got a hand-reared puma.
Gorgeous, isn't she?
She's just been licking my hand.
Oh, that's so cute.
She was completely hand-reared.
What's her name?
Yazzie.
Yazzie.
Oh, she said Yazzie.
Well, I didn't hear what you said. Oh, yeah, it says it out there.
It means little one. She was tiny, tiny, tiny Winnie. She nearly died, so that's why she was hand-reared.
She's beautiful, isn't she? What a lovely face.
She's really playful. She's quite dinky, but she's just lovely. She's got a lovely character. And she does love people.
She's like, hi, guys.
You're all right, I'll film this.
So this is quite a good example of what the cats are capable of. This one here is not quite as bad. This is just one of the toys that we give to the cats. So this would have been a plastic water barrel at one point, covered in lemon zest that smelled nice, and Nias, one of our Sumatran tigers, completely destroyed it. This one's a bit more sinister. So this used to be a flat sheet of metal that we use to separate bedrooms from enclosures. So when we need to go into the enclosures, we can shut the cats in and vice versa. This one was up at the time, so Tiger could go in or out as he pleased, but blowing in the wind, making a racket, getting on his nerves, and this is what he's done to it.
So don't get on their nerves is the moral of this story.
So these are the teeth holes, yeah, the dots. I'll give you an idea of the size of the teeth.
This is Manzy.
Oh,
Manzy. Look at him. He's like, look how beautiful I am.
What a tart. Hi, handsome.
Buddy.
Sorry, what? Could you just repeat that?
Guys, love it when you blow on their nose. Well, he does in particular.
Oh.
He'd probably slow down and he sometimes will sit down.
Death by servos.
What are these? Servals?
Servals. They're servals. African cats, African wild cats. They're
Are they friendly?
they're still wild cats, but they're reasonably, familiar with people. They're
domesticated.
They can jump about 13, 14 feet in there.
Really? That's why it's so high, I guess.
Hi! Are you hissing at me? Huh. Sam's gonna play with the big cats.
Are you ready?
I feel like we're sacrificing you, Sam.
Fishing for a serval.
It was really
Oh.
What is on that then?
A bit of paper.
Just a piece of paper.
Oh.
Scent on,
there's some scent on it. They love it. Go high, Sam. Swing it.
Woohoo!
Got it.
Oh, oh. Boys.
Oh, gosh. You're not even quick enough.
I think you lost.
Oh, you did well there, Soph. Yeah.
You won't be able to get it back.
A bit more agile, Soph.
But they will also catch it easier.
And so you stand with whatever hand you're going to feed with to the fence. You stand not too close. And you get the chicken leg like that, and you tuck your thumb in. So at no stage, she knows what's going to happen. So, hey Layla. So when she can come up, so she will come up here. Oh, that'll be nice. There you go, good girl. So they know how it's going to happen. That's exactly what you do. And generally, most of the cats are quite gentle. So
oh, swapped. Wait, because he was in there before, yeah?
Yeah, this is him. This is.
So they swapped. Right. Okay. Cool.
Do you want to do him?
Yeah.
You know what you're doing, don't you? Are you ready? Okay.
Good oh my boys. Goodness. What I'm really an incredible
how noise. Cool was that?
He's busy.
He's huge. And
he is. The paws. Size of his paws, yeah. You got a leaf in there as well, mate.
Garnish.
Yeah, yeah. Herbs.
Bit of sand. Look at him climbing up. He's awesome. That nice. Oh,
the sound. So strong.
I like those ones. Those are pretty. The size of this tiger. This is Tambo, and you can't really get an idea of how big he is. He's like a freaking dinosaur. He's just laying there grumbling. I think he's eaten too much Sunday roast.
You ready? Good girl.
She likes the camera.
Yeah, she can eat that.
She also likes you because you're injured.
You're injured too. I'll have a bit of that. I can eat you.
She also likes you because you're injured.
You're injured too. I'll have a bit of that. I can eat you.
Oh, it's so chatty.
Hey, Tom.
What are you saying?
Hello.
Oh, it's sleepy.
Good boy. Hey Arta.
This is Arta.
Quite a chatterbox. Hey.
They call him Golden hey, Balls. Can anybody see why?
Comment below.
You're chatty, so aren't you?
The most endangered big cat. The
oh, really?
Most endangered big cat on the planet.
So how many of these are there?
There's between 60 70.
Just make sure I do it right.
Tuck it in there.
Thumb in.
Side on.
Thumb in.
Yeah, thumb in. Turn it round. And then you're going to pass it through sideways.
Like that?
Yep.
Lovely.
That's it. I still have all my fingers, right?
She's quite good, isn't she?
Very
genuine.
Yeah,
pretty good.
You can actually see, see her spots. Yeah, you can see her rosettes. Saying,
she's a girl.
Very pretty.
Okay. That look.
Should I any more food?
That
you
look,
stupid
so.
Humans are getting on my nerves. I feel like she's way too intelligent.
Yeah, yeah. Really like clever.
Thank you.
we're nearly done. We've just got Tiny the lion to go and feed now, which is Sam's favourite, so he's really excited. But my battery's really low, so I'm worried this is going to cut out. But I feel like there's so much here and so much to see, and it's so amazing getting this close to these animals that I can't possibly capture it all on camera, but hopefully this vlog has come across well. I'm also writing a blog post about exactly what they do here, why it's so great for these endangered species and all the good work that they do, so check out my blog if you would like to find out more of that. Tiny's not hungry.
What is that? That is a horse.
Standing up earlier.
It's like a peanut to him, really, isn't it?
Very small.
So he just said a Malteser. I said I'd come down for Malteser.
He's like, oh, all right then.
Come on.
I mean, take your time.
Oh, yeah, never
do I want the Malteser, do I not?
He's going to do it on his time.
Yeah, that's it.
And this was like a deer running around in there, I think.
That might work.
I don't think he even needs to walk down.
I mean, go in, Sam. See if that works.
I'm assuming the glove is the right way for square without.
Oh, he's so pretty.
Oh, good. Stick on to the top. Hey, buddy.
I'm trying to get him off on his back legs, but I'm going to guess he's... Just
he's tired.
Thumb.
Tiny, what's this?
One you don't want to miss.
Nope, right. It's Sunday.
What's this?
I'm
not
jumping out for
Malteser. Wow. He's impressive.
Oh.
We're just on our way home now, but I just thought I would do a little last outro just to explain a couple of things, because I was really hesitant before we went. I don't like zoos, I don't like things like SeaWorld and all of that. Especially at the moment, it's very topical. So I was quite hesitant before we went, and I really wanted to find out exactly what it was all about. But basically, those animals that are there, none of them are, they're all born in captivity. They wouldn't survive in the wild. White tiger that you saw, she used to be in the circus, they rescued her. There's a lion there, I think she said a lion. We didn't see him, he was asleep. Who was a breeding lion in a zoo. If it weren't for them, he probably just would have been put to sleep, because he's old, he's served his purpose and is now redundant. But they took him on because they said he doesn't, you know, just because he's done his breeding program bit, he's going to live out his days there. So you know, these animals wouldn't survive elsewhere, so they're kind of, they've got to go somewhere, and that's the best place for them to be. On top of that, they do so much work, as I think I videoed Tanith, the lady, saying, for conservation and protection of these species, especially the endangered ones. She spoke to us a lot about the threats that they face out in the wild, like trophy hunting, and their habitats are being ruined and built on and stuff like that. So it's really, really, really interesting, and I learned a lot, and I think that they're doing an amazing job. Obviously, they don't really want any animals, any wild animals, in captivity, but the sad fact is that if these guys weren't in captivity, then a lot of these species would be extinct. So they're doing a great job, and they're doing the best that they can do. So yeah, please, as I said, if you're local to them and you fancy a visit, they aren't open to the public most of the time. They have 4 open days a year. It's not a tourist attraction. It is genuinely for the protection of these animals, but obviously they have to raise money somehow. So you can book private visits, I think. And like I said, they have 4 open days a year where you can just go and see for yourself. So I would highly recommend it. And please give them all the support that they deserve. I think I'm just going to finish this vlog here, because hopefully that's been quite something a bit different and a bit exciting for you this week. And it's Sunday evening now, and we are going over to my mum and dad's for something to eat. And I will see you next Monday for another weekly vlog.